Good morning, students. Today I am going to teach you the chapter number 14, construction of class 6. Now see, student, in this construction we have to use the ruler and compass and the protractor. Now see, there is our protractor like this one. Okay, we know that angles start from 0 and go up to 180 degree. That means this is the semicircle, represent the angle 180 degree. Now if we want to make the construction, we use the compass. Now see, I prepare it like this one. I know that the angle start from 0 and end at 180 degree. Now when I draw an arc, how to see, this is one fold I take, this is other fold. That means there are total how many? 1, then 2, then 3. That means this 180 degree angle is divided into 3 equal parts. That means 180 divided by 3, how much will be there? 60 degree. It means when we divide this in 3 parts, each angle will be, there will be 60, then again there will be 60. That full will be 0 to 60, then 60 again 60, 60 plus 60, there will be 120. Again there will be 60, it become 180 degree. Is it clear? Now, when I open my compass, I am taking this compass, we are using only notebook, that the small one. But in on the board we have to use this one. This is my compass. Okay, when I open it, it's upon you, you want to open it 1 centimeter or 1.5 or half, it upon you, how much you want to open it. I just open this compass. Then I draw a semicircle on it, like this one. Open the compass once. How much you open, just stay here. Don't increase or decrease it. When I draw the semicircle and starting from 0 point, that means on the line, first arc, that first arc will be of 60 degree. That means this is the third part of our semicircle. That's why I fold it 3 times. Okay, when I open the compass, first arc will be of 60 degree. Then from this first arc, if I draw the next one, this become 120 degree. From this 120, if I draw the another arc on this semicircle, it become 180 degree. That means if I, with this help, I draw the semicircle, that semicircle, and I have to use this same radius. Don't increase or decrease. If you increase or decrease it, your angles will be wrong. Now I am going to construct on the board. Here, once again, the full is 180 degree. First arc of 60, second arc of 120, third arc of 180. Now we will use this 60, 120 and 180 for our construction. Now see. And once more, 14.1, sum number 1 and 3 that are not in your syllabus, that are contained. From sum number 2, 4, 5 and 6 only these are in your syllabus. 14.1, 14.2 is also not in your syllabus. Only 14.1, sum number 2, 4, 5 and 6. This much is only for construction. Clear? Now I am going to start. Construct the following angles using ruler and compass. First angle I am going to draw the 45 degree. Now listen. First I take a single line. Because if this concept is clear to you, then you can construct any angle. Now I am going to take any line, straight line. I draw it, then with the compass, this pin, okay, if you don't know, just make a point here on the starting of the line with the help of pencil like this, because we have to keep this point on this. Now if I make this point over here, okay, and I open this compass like this one, then I have to draw a semicircle here. This board is white, so that's why this colorful chalk is not visible, but I draw it like this one with the help of this one. Okay. Now I am using this one, you don't use it. You use this only compass. I open this compass, put this point. This much is radius and keep it like this one. Semicircle is there. Now this semicircle touch the line here. There is another point. Same compass put on this point. Okay. There will be a first arc. This is my first arc. That means this is the angle of 60 degree. This is, there is 0. Now first arc is on 60. From this, where the arc cut this semicircle, again point will be there. Cutting point. On that cutting point, I keep my compass. Okay? And again draw another arc. There will be my this arc. Now this become angle of 120 degree. See, first arc on 60. From 60 draw the another one, 120. If I draw from 120, again this point I have to use with the same compass, draw the another arc. There will be, that means there will be angle of 180 degree. This much is clear. Now I want to prepare the angle of 45. Now 45, where to draw? Just for 45, we have to construct the angle of 90 degree. Now I have to think, where the 90 degree lie? 90 degree will, after the 60 degree, but before the 120 degree. That means 90 lie in between these two. That's why, one thing more, 90 lie between these two, and I can take here 90, 30, increase to 60, become 90. 30 decrease from 120, also be 90. That means 90 is the middle value between 60 and 120. So what to do? Take the same compass, from this 60, draw an arc here, like this one. I draw an arc here. Another, from this 120, again there. This one. That means if I join it with the help of scale. Now, two arcs will cut here. This joining point I have to make with it. This become the angle of 90 degree. But I need the 45. Now how to prepare the 45? 45 is the middle value of 90 and 0. That means I will use this 90 and this 0 degree. First I take my compass with the same radius. I am repeating again and again. Don't increase or decrease it. Just from the 0 degree, I draw an arc here. This is my arc. Okay, then from 90 degree, that means I will take this 90 degree and draw another arc on this one. Here, now two arcs will cancel here. That means this is the common point. This common point I have to join with this 0, there, starting point. Now it's my angle of 45 degree. Now too many angles are in this book, you are given 30 degree, 60 degree, that already clear. First arc with 60. If 60 is given, just draw a line here, like this one. It becomes the angle of 60. If the angle is given 120, just like the draw from here to 120. Okay, but 45, I know between 90 and 0 degree. Okay. And 90 also clear. If I draw 1 to the angle of 105. Now imagine 105, where for 105 from 120, sorry, back, we have to come back from 120, but forward from 90 degree. 90. That means 90 plus 15, but 120, 120 minus 15. That becomes again mid value. How to mid value find? Take these two points, where the mid value is there. That means I will take the same compass with at 90 degree and at 120 degree. 120 one arc and 90 from the second arc. Again this one. That means this common point becomes the angle of 105. Clear? These are the angles in your book. Then the next concept. Sum number 4. Draw a line segment and construct the perpendicular bisect. What is the meaning of perpendicular? That means angle of 90 degree. But here we are not going to draw the angle of 90 degree. He said perpendicular and bisector. Bi means two equal parts, two sector, equal two parts. Now how to construct that one? I will take the line segment of 6 cm. This is the line of 6 cm. I give it the name as AB. Now I want to draw the perpendicular bisector. Now I have to open my compass more than half. It is 6 cm, I can open it 4, I can open it 5. As you wish. More than half, I have to open my compass.
That means more than 3 because this is 6 cm. When I take more than half like this way, then from the starting point A, I have to draw an arc above the line and there will be below the line. See this one. This is the above line and this is the below line. Okay, then from this B point with the same compass, I draw the another that will cut it. Now, from the common points, I have to draw the line. This is the perpendicular bisector of AB. Then, sum number 6. Draw a line segment PQ 7 cm. Now, one line is given PQ, that is 7 cm. P. Mark any point M, anywhere. I taken a point M here, anywhere on our piece. Then from this point I have to draw a perpendicular on it. That means from this point I have to construct the angle of 90 degree on it. But it is not possible to take a point and construct the angle of 90 degree. On a line we can construct, already we construct. But how to prepare it? Now see, open your compass, put it at point M, okay? You have to open this compass from M point and from this point increase. The length we have to increase. From M point, I have to take up to this one. More than this line, distance. Then I will draw a semicircle like this one. I have a mark on the board, on that I am putting the marker. This I make. Then, from this starting point, from this ending point, I have to take the two arcs again. From this point, first one is this one, and from this point, I have to take this one. Like this one. Two will be cut it, then I have to join this point with the M. Now it becomes the angle of 90 degree and perpendicular bisector of PQ. That means this part will be 3.5 and this is also 3.5. Perpendicular bisector that divides the line into equal parts. Clear, student? And listen to me, the sum number 4, only 5 is there and few parts of second are there. That is your triangle. Only few sums are there, only 4 sums you can see. This is too much small. And you have to just listen that concept when we draw the semicircle, that become 180 degree. With the same radius, when we started the arcs, that become the angle of 60 degree. Where the arc cut the semicircle, that point we have to use. Okay? Thank you. Please try to do the sum. Thank you very much.